feels so stupid. A Morehouse man is supposed to feel stupid.
I didn't want to come over here and talk about this.
Well, you haven't said anything yet, Dan.
Well, it's just that when I saw Claire and Denise together like that, it made me think of Cindy and Irma.
What's wrong with that?
Sarah's fine.
Okay, good.
The problem is Cindy.
What's wrong with Cindy?
Cocaine, alcohol.
You're kidding me.
We just put her back into a rehab center. It's the third one she's been in a year and a half. See, when Sarah and I first found out that she had this problem, we sat her down, talked to her. We told her that we loved her very much, that we would do anything to help her. See, she said she wanted help. So we sent her to the counselor. She just wasn't getting better, you know, so we found the best rehabilitation center in the city. It worked. She got out, it was like Sarah and I had our little baby again. About 3 or 4 weeks, everything was fine. And she disappeared. 3 days, she was gone. Sarah and I were going crazy. The police couldn't even find her. And then in the middle of the night, got a phone call. Daddy, please, can I come home? Come get me. Well, we put her back into the rehab center. This time when she got out, she said to me, Daddy, I'm gonna make it this time. Everything's going to be fine. For a couple of months, everything was fine. And money started disappearing from Sarah's purse. Mm. I started seeing changes in Cindy. Physically, she wasn't right. I mean, did she think we were so stupid that we couldn't see these things? I want to know, how did it get into my house? What was she doing with it? Oh, Cliff, this is killing me. Killing a mother, and it's ripping my family apart. I just want to know, what did you do? How did you keep it from your kids?
I don't know. I know that Claire and I do the same thing that you and Sarah have done. It's just luck, I don't know. It sounds like you and Sarah have done all you can. It's up to Cindy now. Does she know she's tearing up the family? You want me to talk to her?
No, if I've had people she respects talk to.
I beg your pardon.
I don't mean it that way. I mean people that she loves and that she knows have sat down with her one-on-one. And it doesn't make any difference. Yet.
Maybe this time, Cindy will do it. There's nothing more I can say.
Me too.
Well, that's about the first time a Morehouse man has had nothing to say.
Or came to a human man for advice.
Come on.